Hi, assalamualaikum and a very good day to everyone watching this video. My name is Hawa Christina Betty Mamanjis and I'm from class 504. Today, I'm going to explain about a topic called polymer. The title of my project based on learning is flower pot. So, let's start. These are the contents of my video. First and foremost, I would like to express my deepest appreciation to all of my chemistry teacher, Mrs. Atika, our batch coordinator teacher, and Mrs. Siti Soleha, my class teacher, who helped me to complete this project-based learning PBL. Special thanks to my parents for providing me a comfortable study place and facilities. The objective of this project-based on learning is to define polymers. Other than that, to give explanation on the process of addition polymerization and condensation. To justify the use of polymers in daily life, to produce a useful product using recyclable polymers, and lastly, to suggest ways to overcome the problem related to polymers. Next, this is the learning process report for my project. Introduction about polymer. What is polymer? Polymer is a long-chain molecule that is made from a combination of many repeating basic units. The basic unit of a polymer is known as monomer. The monomer combination reaction is to produce a polymer is called a polymerization reaction. There are some examples of source of polymer and the polymer and their monomer. Next, there are three types of polymer. Thermoplastic polymer, that is a polymer that can be repeatedly remolded upon heating and can be recycled. For example, nylon. Other than that, thermosetting polymer. Thermosetting polymer cannot be remolded after heating. For example, melamine. And lastly, elastomer polymer. This polymer can be stretched and can return to their original shape when released. For example, polyurethane. Okay, so now I'm going to present about addition polymerization process. Addition polymerization occurs when monomers that have double covalent bond between two carbon atoms, C double bond C, react with one another. During the reaction, the double bond is opened and the monomer are added to the molecule chain to produce a polymer. And as you can see on the photo that I attached. Other than that, there are condensation polymerization. Condensation polymerization involves at least two different monomers. The monomer involved consists of two functional groups that will take part in the polymerization reaction. The product of condensation polymerization is a polymer and another byproduct such as water or hydrochloric acid molecule. Yay! It's time for me to explain about my project. These are the list of apparatus and material that I use for my project, which are scissor, cutter, plastic bottle, and spray paint. Okay, now let's watch the video of me doing the project.
Hi, today I'm going to make a flower pot using a plastic bottle. Let's start. The first step is to cut the upper part of the bottle using a cutter. So next, I'm going to cut a little bit of this part. Okay, I'm going to cut this part like this. It will be like this. Then next, use this and put it here. Bend this part of the bottle and put it here. Repeat this step until all of it done. Okay, so yay, we're done. So next, we're going to paint this flower pot using a paint. I'm using a red color. And make sure you wear a mask during the process. Yay, our flower pot is done. So you need to make a hole on the below to if you want to put a flower in it.
Product description and impact. This product gives many impact to the surrounding. First of all, is this product can reduce greenhouse gas emission, as well as can use as a decoration for garden. And most importantly, this flower pot save your money instead of buying a new pot. Moreover, this flower pot can reduce the amount of plastic packaging in our daily life and also promote recycling activities. Conclusions and science concept. As you guys know, polymers are widely used in our daily life. For example, plastic bag, and various medical and laboratory apparatus which are made of polypropylene. This polymer increased their demand and uses over years. Some of the polymer are durable and take a very long time to disintegrate that cause a very serious pollution problem. Marine pollution causes many creatures to die and microplastic to enter the food chain. Fortunately, there are methods to overcome this problem. The easiest way for consumers to overcome this problem is by recycling. Recycling can ensure that synthetic polymer do not end up in landfill, and also the introduction of degradable polymers, particularly for plastic products, it enables pollution to be reduced. Additives are added to enable plastics to decompose naturally by bacteria or decompose by light. Plastic products will decompose faster, and this will reduce the plastic dumping issue, which is very good. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy. Bye!